He was now an international figure, you see. And he told me all about the work that he had done, showed me newspaper cuttings and so on.
All of a sudden, one day he came to office and he said, "I want to go to America." I said, "Are you crazy? Why do you want to go there? What will you do? You know, American government, you know, sometimes they are very funny. They'll send you back. So once, you know, it goes on record that you have sent back, then they won't let you in. Why do you want to go?" And at that time, you know, so many people were not going to America. Now it is quite different. So I said, "Why do you want to go? Kya karega?" I used to say, "Are buddha mar jayega khali." So he won't listen.
What does it mean?
Die man, the old man, you are going to die like this, that. Who will look after you? What will you do then? So he said, "Kya karo, jana, jana, jana." I said, "All right, I'll make this arrangement, then you go." So when the arrangement was made, he was in Bombay. I made all this arrangement with the captain and the ship went to load some ports. His wife went for that. Then they came back. At that time, our other ship dropped him. From Calcutta. So the other ship went and dropped him there. And then he went by that ship.
He was residing before he left India. He was staying in a dharamshala, that is free lodging and all of that in North Calcutta. And I had taken him off from there by a taxi. Immediately we rushed to Khidirpuchok and all that. A very early morning at about 5:30. I said nothing, but I was very much shocked that he was leaving us. Immediately he realized our mental position and he advised me, "Don't be worried. I'll soon be returning to India and I'll take your news and all of that. Let me come back."
I used to talk on telephone with him. Because I had told the captain that you see that he talks to me. So there is no trouble for him. So he used to. And you know this Gokulashtami day?
Yes.
Krishna Janmashtami?
Yes.
He was in Suez. So he phoned me, captain phoned me. He said on board they had to cross the Suez Canal. So they were there. So captain phoned me. So today is the Gokulashtami and on board the ship we are having a meeting and Swamiji will talk to us and then we will distribute sweets which we got and everyone. And then we will have some bhajan record playing and all that.
I was associated with in the same compartment in the ship, that cabin, because that was a cargo ship, that was not a passenger ship. So apart from the captain's room, one apartment was there, an extra, and he was offered that room to go to himself. And after reaching Boston port, I got a letter from him. And from that letter, I was informed he was attacked twice in heart attack in the same ship in a journey of 23 days to reach over to Boston. And immediately he asked me to send a medicine, that Ayurvedic. Well, he mentioned the name of that medicine. I immediately rushed to the shop and bought it. Immediately sent it to him by air post. And he acknowledged that medicine and told me that at that time my mental balance was not so quite good because of his sickness and all other. because he was quite aged at that time. And it was obvious to become sorrow or a father. After all, he was our father. So immediately I sent this medicine to him in his address in USA. And he acknowledged it and he was being recovered very fast, very rapid. And we all of our families were pleased.
I talked with the Swamiji also on telephone. So he said, no, I'm quite all right, but I am very seasick. So I was talking to this captain and all that, said, tell me, little mother, that I am going to die now. He was very much seasick. So he was not feeling comfortable. So he phoned me also. I said, Ara, you are not going to die, don't worry. Seasickness doesn't kill anybody. Then he was not feeling very comfortable because the sea is not very good on that side. Little rough. So then when he reached New York, that captain phoned me. Okay, we have reached. And I talked to Swamiji. He said yes.
He went to Warden Road, Akash Ganga, where the Hare Krishna devotee was staying. I went there and met to Swami Madhu Visa, who was the in charge of the devotees. I sat for few minutes, then I was told by Madhu Visa that Guruji came just now from America and sitting another room. So you come with me and take the darshan of Guruji. So I went to that room with Madhu Visa and take the darshan of Guruji. After sitting some time, Guruji asked me, where are you living? I said, I am living at Goregaon, suburb of Bombay. Then Guruji asked, what are you doing? That I said, my business is construction. So Guruji asked, when you are getting up early in the morning, and what are you doing? Then I said, when I getting up in the morning, I am taking one cup of tea, then going to toilet, and taking bath, and then going on work. Then Guruji suddenly said, what is difference between pig and you? You are just like a pig. Then I said, yes, Maharaj, please advise me that how can change my life. Then Guruji said, you must do to service of Krishna. Then I said, I have not associated any spiritual movement or the saint or the devotees. So Guruji said, from tomorrow my devotees will come to your house early in the morning, and then you do the Nagar Sankirtan there with my devotees, and then all the devotees will take feast, lunch at your home, and you will be involved in this way in the spiritual movement.
One day, while giving Prabhupada his prasadam, I asked him, Prabhupada, what is your favorite preparation? Prabhupada replied, saying that he likes all the preparations. I inquired again, no, Prabhupada, what is your most favorite preparation? Then Prabhupada said that his favorite preparation is shukta. So I used to cook four or five types of shukta for Prabhupada every day. Whenever I would take Prabhupada his prasadam, he would say, "You have cooked so much prasadam for me, but first give me the shukta." So I would always give Prabhupada his shukta first.
When we purchased this land, Hare Krishna land, there was living so many characterless peoples who were doing the liquor business, and there were also, after some time,